Kelley, for the past year and a half, we have been focused on the pandemic, perhaps reassessing our plans, our finances, and retirement savings may not have been top of mind. Are we behind when it comes to our retirement savings?
It's such a great question, Larysa, because so many people are feeling that. I mean, just the pandemic has swallowed up so much of their life. It either feels like 10 years or 2 days, depending on who you talk to. But the reality is there's a lot of stress around finances and retirement planning. A recent Manulife survey really paints a picture of how much stress there is when it comes to people's finances. Respondents saying 51% saying that they're going to have to take some type of financial action because of the pandemic. Two-thirds, no surprise here, that they would feel so much more productive if they didn't have to worry about money. So when it comes to something like retirement, it's such a long-term goal, or it can be, that it's kind of like this looming, using the bandwidth in your brain. So the good news is that with some planning, with some, you know, chunking it down, knowing what steps you need to take, it can just alleviate so much of that stress and uncertainty.
You and I have often talked about what goes into a budget, and I've heard you say countless times it's about having a plan. So let's talk about having a financial plan for your retirement. What are the factors that go into that?
And so many people think that they need to do it on their own. And you're right, Larysa, we have talked about this so many times. So, you know, you really need to start with engaging with your future self. Now, this sounds so simplistic, but if you haven't taken the time to do that, even a financial planner will have a difficulty creating that plan for you. So you need to step into the future. Where will you live? Will you still have a mortgage? What type of expenses will you incur? And what kind of retirement do you want to have? Now, something that can really derail a lot of financial plans, and especially retirement plans, is things like unexpected medical costs. Now, we have free healthcare in Canada, but you have to really budget and calculate these things, and it's difficult. So you might want to look at a benefit plan like Manulife's health and dental. You also want to realize, Larysa, I know this sounds axiomatic, but there's kind of like this great resignation going on right now. And a lot of people leaving their company early, or they are forced out. And what a lot of people don't realize too is they may be losing benefits, or just not digging in to make sure that you and your spouse aren't actually paying for the same type of benefits at work. So all of these little things add to questions that you're going to want to sit down to get answers from your financial planner, and really reach out to a professional, because they're going to help carry that financial load for you. If it's a fee-only planner that you see for one-time planning, if it's an ongoing advisor to walk you through a lot of these complexities, but they're going to be your GPS. They're going to be that navigational system for you. So if and when the unexpected happens, if it's death, divorce, early retirement, you've got that plan in place, and you know how to recalibrate when things change.
What if your budget just does not allow for this right now?
And so many people are feeling that. Such a great question. So the reality is we're seeing inflation at an 18-year high. I mean, going into winter is going to be very expensive. So if it's not possible right now, give yourself a break, first of all. Realize that the future may be better than you think. You may have a job in the near future that pays much better. When will you be mortgage free, that you don't have that large expenditure? And here's a way to look at some extra income that you may not have thought about, is really digging into your employer pension plan. Today is a great day to call up your HR department and see if there's any benefits that you're leaving on the table. The fact is that it's estimated that $3 to $4 billion is left on the table every single year by Canadians not taking advantage of matching programs at work, group RSPs. That is free money that's just yours to claim. So definitely, if you are traditionally employed, dig into those benefits plans at your work.
Kelley, you had mentioned some of the elements that go into that retirement calculator, but tell us, what are your options if you run out of savings?
Absolutely. And that is such a fear for so many people, that they won't have the savings for their retirement or for long-term care or to help out their parents or kids. So I think a great strategy is to remember you can still work in retirement. I mean, there is something called Encore Careers that people are really leaning into, not just for the financial aspect of it, but also because we know from the countless studies out there that your brain is sharper when you're engaged in work and something that you're passionate about. And just you're going to probably live longer and have more fun. But the reality is, if you sit down with your planner and just factor in a small percentage of what you earned during your working years, 10%, 20%, 30% as an encore career, you would be absolutely shocked what a difference that can make to your retirement. So something I actually have recommended in a couple of my books is for people to budget during their working years for a sabbatical. Now, it doesn't have to be a huge one. It doesn't have to be a whole year or 6 months, but a great way to start to test those passions that you can then take into retirement, maybe even build up those skill sets. So when your traditional retirement happens, you now have an ability to lean into these passions, your skills are ready, and it can also help fund your retirement so you're not running out of money.
Kelley, you had touched on some of the aspects. Let's just get into it a little bit more. You're retired, and now what?
Absolutely. So now it's essential that you're preserving what you have. And I think, again, that planner is even more important because, you know, you can never retire from your money, just like you can't retire from your health, right? It's not just this event and it's done. You really need to dig into your investments. This is going to be the most important time to really assess your risk analysis, like how much risk are you taking? What is your plan for reducing the risk of your assets as you move into a RIF and start to dip into those funds and have that balance of you know, what are you going to need for cash flow? What's going to remain invested? You also really have to have a keen awareness of how that income is going to be reflected by changes in inflation, in interest rates. Like all of this just means that you have to be paying attention to your money even so much more to make sure that what you've preserved is there for you and also is fulfilling maybe gifts to charities or to your family, whatever is important.